I'm making a few toy rabbits for Christmas. This is a design out of Korea, and the link for this will be in the description for the video. I have the rabbit made. I wanted to make this of cherry, but all the cherry in the shops around here is very pale, so this is red oak. And the wheels are red oak. So now, I need to round over the edge of these wheels. This is a fairly large round over for a small part, and I do not want to get my fingers in here while I'm trying to do this. So I made a jig, and this just fits on there. Now this pin does not have to be the same size as that. Its job is just to keep this from turning. So we put that on there. Round over the part with relative safety. Take it off, turn it over, and do it again. Now this is red oak. Oak of any type always seems to burn when you're doing something like this. So I just live with it, and I chuck this up in the drill and sand it, get rid of the burn marks. I drilled these holes a little bit undersized. I'll just shove a piece of dowel in there. And get rid of the burn marks. I don't have a color printer, but this is yellow heart for the eye. It goes into the rabbit. It will stick out just a little bit proud. And I took a piece of walnut and turned it into a 1/4-inch doll. That'll be glued in there and sanded flush. The next problem, or I should say adventure, is how to round over this eye without this coming back and hitting me in the face or losing a finger. Made a jig, drilled a hole the same size as what's in the rabbit head. Notch this out so it will clear this bearing. Split it on the bandsaw. Put some clamping screws in here. Once I split this, when these screws are tightened up, this will clamp onto this eye. Push that down until the clamp and this piece of yellow heart are flush with the surface. Tighten up the screws. Then I can hold this and route that piece to get that round over. Once again, this will burn, as did this. Just chuck it up in a lathe or a cordless drill and sand it. So that's in there. You don't have to tighten these real tight. You can see it's just touching here and here, and that holds onto that very firmly. Times than not, it takes longer to make the jigs and fixtures than it does the part. Just like in a machine shop. Piece of 1/4-inch rod that's a little bit tight on here. Needs a little more sanding, but it doesn't take long. you have some boards that aren't suited for anything else, knots, cracks, splits, just use the good part. When we get ready to make the feet and the legs, there are left and right hand versions, but they have exactly the same hole spacing. Then on these pieces, there's also left and right, and this section, and all of these have the same hole spacing. These get rounded over on one side, and you want to round over the side with the pattern. So I made a jig that will work with all of these. But the main pin fits pretty snug on that hole. And then you have a small pin, a little bit loose. When you drill these, you may be off just a little bit. So if you try to use exactly the same size pin, you may have a problem. And this will work for any of these. Then on this one, you use the other side. That will fit there. And that gives you control.